My name is Loy van Beek from the Bleo Project from the Netherlands. We are based in Eindhoven. For Rosin, we worked on a full coverage path planner and a local planner to go with it. So a bit about Nobleo. Nobleo is a high-tech consultancy and projects company based in Eindhoven, Netherlands. And we do our projects and work in robotics, mechatronics, and related stuff. Our customers include companies like ASML, NXP. I consulted for a couple of years for Ultimaker, for example. My name is Loy van Beek, and I've been at Nobleo since 2015. I joined the project branch this year, but most of my robotics experience is based on RoboCup at Home with Tech United Eindhoven. So what full coverage path planning, what is it? Making sure that the robot goes to every place it can reach within a map. And you need this for cleaning, painting, inspection, the kind of topics. But unfortunately, there is no full coverage path planner available in ROS Industrial, or even in ROS. In ROS, there is Automo, made by Auburn University. But it's been a while since the last commit. There's no documentation. It's all written for a competition years ago. The maps are represented as vectors instead of grids, which is typical in ROS. And also it's written in Python using a geometry library, which is, of course, not available in C++. So for ROSin, we developed a minimal viable product, just past stage one. And the requirements for this, of the main requirements were to have this the map known as an occupancy grid in ROS, that there were no dynamic obstacles, which is typical for the environments at least that we use it in. If there's any obstacles, that will be handled by the local planner. And so we developed this global planner that does full coverage and a local planner to accurately follow this global path. I am mostly presenting work done by colleagues of me, Yuri Brodsky, who developed the algorithm, implemented the algorithm, and Michiel, who is currently working for ASML, also as a control engineer. So my work has mostly been some refactoring, making it plugins for Movebase in ROS, and writing some tests. So the algorithm that we use is called the backtracking spiral algorithm, which was developed by Enrique Gonzalez in 2005. And this essentially works by first discretizing the map to the size of the robot, and then by planning moving robot up to a wall, and then make a spiral all the way to in the middle of the spiral. Then plan to free space again and repeat the process. That's the core of how it works. This core algorithm is separated from ROS, which allows for easier testing and also to easier to port it to ROS 2.0 later on. Currently, it's wrapped as a base global planner, so you can just plug it into Movebase or even Movebase Flex. Per the definition of the problem, the goal, typically in Movebase, you move from A, from where the robot is currently, to a point B, where you want the robot to go. In this case, there is no point B. Point B is essentially everywhere. So in this case, we ignore this bit. Point B is ignored, typically. So this is roughly what this looked like. On the left, you see the interior of our office. And on the right is a very large care environment. This from one place to the other is from one corner to the other is couple of hundred meters, I think. So it also works on quite large, of relatively large maps. There was supposed to be a picture in here as well, or a little movie. What you typically see with local planners is that they are intended to move from, also they assume that the global plan is also moving from A to B. But if typically in a full coverage path, the robot is going back and forth and to cover a large area. But the typical local planner does not deal with this very well. They go back and forth and in some local optimum or something, so they don't get anywhere. So for that, we developed our own local planner. which has the goal to accurately follow a path, but then also do it reproducible. So in order to achieve full coverage, it's important that the robot does not deviate from the path. And because of the typical deployment environment, it's okay if there is a dynamic obstacle to just wait for it to go away. In the application that we currently use it in, that's fine. And as I said, what's peculiar about this this application of full coverage is that you do not go from A to B as soon as possible, so where you can skip parts of the plan. No, you have to stick to the plan. So this how this control actually works is we have this full coverage plan. We slide a goal over it, essentially the carrot that the robot should follow. And the controller picks up on the X and Y arrow and adjusts for it. Which is different from what you would have, for example, in the typical move-based DWA planner, where the robot continuously plans a path to find the shortest way to achieve the goal. But in this case, when the robot deviates from the path, it tries to go back to where it should be on the path instead of making a new plan. So this also implements the typical API that you follow for a local planner, but the core again is ROS independent. Very handy about this. Of course, if you have a controller, you want to be able to live tune all the parameters. That's what you see here. All the parameters are live tunable, and in the also all the intermediate outputs of the PID phases of your controller are all you can independently debug them. We made use of the very handy plot juggler application, made also available in the ROS community, which is very handy for us. So one application that we have for this is a wall cleaning robot. I also included a video which seems to have dropped out. But very interesting about this, so this is a robot that works on a vertical metal wall. And it has a couple of magnets on the bottom, so it sticks to the wall. What's very interesting about this is that the wheels shear a lot. So these are big rubber wheels, and due to gravity, the robot sags a bit down. And if you would have, for example, have the robot purely horizontal and would drive straight forward, it would gradually drift downwards, which is not what we want. And for example, this tracking PID controller takes care that the robot is slightly tilted so that when it would normally slide downward, it will now stick perfectly to the plan. So if you look at the movie online, you'll see that indicated. Another application that we're working on is this Runmarine Wayshark. It's a startup company from South Africa, and they are developing a robot that is currently also deployed in, for example, the harbor of, I think, Abu Dhabi, to clean up floating waste. There we use the tracking PD local controller, or also as a separate ROS node, to serve, for example, as a virtual anchor. We were testing last week, and the wind was blowing really, really hard, but the robot perfectly kept its place using GPS and its tracking PID stuff. As for testing, which is very important for us, for ROS in, is so what we did was the original code was not really meant to be tested, so I refactored it a bit to make all the stuff that is not entirely ROS dependent in separate files and separate classes, so we could properly unit test it with the standard ROS unit test framework. Interesting, we generate about 1,000 random maps, and we compare this against an OpenCV flood fill. So just use the map as an image, drop the paint bucket, and everywhere where the virtual paint goes, that's where the robot should also go. And this works. That's imparted part of our unit testing. We run these tests using the ROS Industrial CI scripts. in our Bitbucket code hosting. We did notice one minor error though in the already provided script for ROS Industrial CI for Bitbucket. The script was not executable, so I made the tiniest pull request I think I've ever made, just change the permissions to be executable. As for Rosin, we think it's a great initiative. It requires to make our software a bit more generic and develop more thoroughly, also for documentation and for testing. But we also have a lot of things still to do. For example, the wall cleaning robot, due to its placement of the magnets, it's not okay for the robot to drive downward. And we would like to include that constraint into the global planning as well. There's also possibility to add different coverage algorithms that not take spirals but more strokes, for example, and generate more tests. For example, for Python, there is Python Hypothesis, which automatically generates some test cases. Would be nice to use that as well for a C++ code as well. With that, I would like to thank you for your attention. And if there's any questions, you're most welcome.
So, are there questions?
Well, if there's none, then we have time for the next speaker.
Thank you very much, Lloyd.